The universe is vast. It is bigger than we can imagine, stretching far beyond the limits of our comprehension. Its size is almost impossible to grasp, with distances so immense they boggle the mind. Even with the most powerful telescopes, we only see a fraction of what is out there, a mere glimpse into the vast expanse. The universe is also constantly expanding, a phenomenon that has been occurring since the Big Bang. This means that the space between galaxies is growing, stretching the fabric of space-time itself. The farther away a galaxy is, the faster it is moving away from us, a concept known as redshift. This makes the universe even more mind-boggling to consider as it continues to expand and evolve. How can we even begin to understand something so vast and mysterious? It is a question that has puzzled humanity for centuries. It starts with looking up at the night sky where countless stars twinkle like distant beacons. Every star we see is a sun, like our own, each with its own unique characteristics and potential. And around many of those stars, there are planets, some of which may harbor the conditions necessary for life. Some of those planets may even be capable of supporting life, raising the possibility that we are not alone in the universe. The universe is full of possibilities, with countless phenomena waiting to be discovered and understood. It is a place of wonder and awe, a testament to the beauty and complexity of the cosmos. And it is ours to explore, a boundless frontier that invites us to seek out new knowledge and understanding. Our journey begins at home, in our solar system, a fascinating and complex system that has intrigued humanity for centuries. This system is dominated by the Sun, a star of immense energy and gravity, providing the necessary warmth and light for life on Earth. Orbiting the Sun are 8 planets, each with its own unique characteristics, from the scorching surface of Mercury to the icy winds of Neptune. Closest to the Sun are the rocky planets, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. These terrestrial planets have solid rocky surfaces and are relatively small in size. Beyond Mars lies the asteroid belt, a region of rocky debris left over from the solar system's formation. This belt contains countless asteroids, varying in size from tiny pebbles to massive boulders. Further out, we find the gas giants, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. These planets are known for their massive sizes and thick atmospheres. These planets are much larger than the inner planets and are composed mostly of gas and ice. They also have numerous moons and, in the case of Saturn, stunning rings. Even further still lies the Kuiper Belt, a region of icy bodies similar to the asteroid belt. This distant area is home to many small, icy objects that orbit the Sun. This is where we find dwarf planets like Pluto, which was once considered the 9th planet of our solar system before being reclassified. The solar system is vast, but it is just a tiny speck in the grand scheme of the universe. Our solar system resides in the Milky Way galaxy, which itself is just one of billions of galaxies in the universe. Our solar system resides in the Milky Way galaxy, a vast collection of stars, gas, and dust. The Milky Way is a barred spiral galaxy with a central bulge and spiral arms that extend outward. Our solar system is located in one of these spiral arms, about 2/3 of the way out from the center. The Milky Way contains hundreds of billions of stars, many of which are similar to our own Sun. It is difficult to comprehend the scale of our galaxy. It is so large that it would take light, traveling at 186,000 miles per second, about 100,000 years to travel from one end of the Milky Way to the other. And yet, even the Milky Way is just one of billions of galaxies in the observable universe. To measure the vast distances between stars and galaxies, astronomers use a unit called a light year. A light year is the distance that light travels in one year, which is about 5.88 trillion miles. For example, the nearest star to our Sun, Proxima Centauri, is about 4.24 light years away. This means that the light we see from Proxima Centauri today left the star 4.24 years ago. When we look at distant galaxies, we are seeing light that has been traveling through space for millions or even billions of years. This means that we are seeing these galaxies as they were in the distant past. The concept of light years not only helps us measure cosmic distances, but also allows us to look back in time and study the history of the universe. Section 5. Beyond Our Galaxy. A Universe of Galaxies. As we venture beyond the Milky Way, we encounter a universe teeming with galaxies. Galaxies come in various shapes and sizes, including spirals, ellipticals, and irregulars. Some galaxies exist in isolation, while others are grouped together in clusters or superclusters. The Andromeda Galaxy, our nearest galactic neighbor, is a spiral galaxy located about 2.5 million light-years away. The Hubble Deep Field, an image captured by the Hubble Space Telescope, revealed thousands of galaxies in a seemingly empty patch of sky. This image provided further evidence that our universe is filled with an unfathomable number of galaxies. Each galaxy contains billions or even trillions of stars, and it is estimated that there are trillions of galaxies in the observable universe. Section 6. Ancient Light. Distant Echoes. The Age of the Universe. By studying the light from distant galaxies, astronomers have determined that the universe is about 13.8 billion years old. This remarkable discovery was made possible through the observation of light that has traveled across the cosmos for billions of years, carrying with it the secrets of the universe's past. This means that the universe has a beginning, a point in time when it came into existence. The concept of a universe with a definitive starting point has profound implications for our understanding of everything around us. The prevailing theory for the origin of the universe is the Big Bang theory. This theory suggests that all matter and energy were once concentrated in an incredibly small and dense point, which then rapidly expanded. According to this theory, the universe began from an extremely hot and dense state and has been expanding and cooling ever since. This expansion has allowed galaxies, stars, and planets to form, creating the vast and complex cosmos we observe today. Evidence for the Big Bang includes the cosmic microwave background radiation, a faint afterglow of the Big Bang that permeates all of space. This radiation provides a snapshot of the early universe, offering clues about its initial conditions and subsequent evolution. The universe's age and expansion raise profound questions about its ultimate fate. As we look deeper into space, we are also looking back in time, trying to piece together the story of the universe's journey. Will it continue to expand forever, or will it eventually collapse back in on itself? These questions drive much of modern cosmological research, as scientists seek to understand the forces that govern the universe's destiny. The answer to this question remains a mystery. However, each new discovery brings us closer to understanding the true nature of the cosmos and our place within it. Section 7. Voids in the Tapestry. Cosmic Emptiness. While the universe is filled with galaxies, it is also home to vast regions of almost complete emptiness, known as cosmic voids. These voids are some of the largest structures in the universe, spanning hundreds of millions of light years. Cosmic voids are not completely empty, but contain a very low density of matter compared to the rest of the universe. The existence of these voids provides clues about the distribution of matter in the universe and the processes that led to its formation. The study of cosmic voids is still in its early stages, and astronomers are actively working to understand their properties and origins. These enigmatic regions of emptiness continue to challenge our understanding of the universe's structure. Section 8. The Observable Universe. A Window to the Cosmos. The observable universe is the portion of the universe that we can currently observe from Earth. It is limited by the finite speed of light and the age of the universe. Because light takes time to travel, when we look at distant objects, we are seeing them as they were in the past. The farthest we can see is determined by the age of the universe, which is about 13.8 billion years. This means that the observable universe has a radius of about 46.5 billion light years in all directions from Earth. It is important to note that the observable universe is not the same as the entire universe. There may be regions of the universe beyond what we can currently observe. Section 9. the unknowable horizon. Is the universe infinite? The question of whether the universe is infinite or finite is one of the most fundamental questions in cosmology. While we can observe a vast portion of the universe, we cannot see beyond the observable universe. Therefore, we cannot say for certain whether the universe extends infinitely in all directions or whether it has a boundary. Some theories suggest that the universe may be finite, but unbounded, like the surface of a sphere. In this scenario, you could travel in any direction and eventually end up back where you started without ever encountering an edge. The concept of an infinite or finite universe has profound implications for our understanding of its nature and our place within it. Section 10. Our place in the cosmic tapestry. As we contemplate the vastness of the universe, it is humbling to realize how small and insignificant we are in comparison. And yet, our existence in this grand cosmic tapestry is nothing short of extraordinary. We are made of the same stardust that makes up the stars and galaxies. The atoms in our bodies were forged in the hearts of stars that lived and died billions of years ago. We are a part of the universe, and the universe is a part of us. The vastness of the universe should not make us feel small, but rather inspire us to explore and learn more about our place in it. We have only just begun to scratch the surface of understanding the cosmos, and there is still so much more to discover.